everyone, it's Alexis from Sims VIP. I hope you're all doing well. So welcome to another Sims Mobile playthrough. This is part 4, and guess what? We're finally getting married and we're finally having a baby. So I am really excited about this. It took me like 4 days to get to this point. So the last time we left off, I think I was at like level 8, I believe, in the game at least, and I had to be a level 12 in order to even unlock the wedding arc, because that's the only way to get married. And then in order to get the wedding arc, you also have to unlock two other items that are required to get married. So it's like, as soon as you think like you're there, you're like not, and there's like another step. So I finally got through that. Luckily, like I had mentioned in the last video, my hubby had some extra money on his Google Play, so I went ahead and I used up the $6.82 or whatever it cost me to buy a stack of sim cash, because I needed it. In order for me to actually get through this, I had to purchase like motive filling and stuff like that, because literally it drains you when you're doing all these different actions. And then the worst part is that they age every day. So as soon as you think that, you know, your Sims are going to be all right, they're almost about to turn into elders. So I was like, I got to do something here before they die. And I can't even go through anything as far as marriage, babies, and even like toddlers and stuff like that. I kind of want to see how it works. So what I've done here is I went ahead and I changed up the original house a little bit. Now, I'm not a builder, so I really, like, I'm not that great at this stuff. So I kind of just, like, made a bedroom and a bathroom on the side and, like, extended the kitchen living room area. Now, this is kind of giving you a look at build mode, too. There's really not much you can do in build mode except for, like, making the rooms larger or smaller. Now, mind you, if you look around, the grid in the background might show that I, like, technically own that property. However, anywhere where you see flowers or like a grass, like, you know, shrubs and stuff on top of the actual lawn, that actually requires you to be a level 15 to clear space. So there's a lot more to that that I haven't even gotten into yet, because I'm only at a level 12. I literally, at this point in the video, I'm 2 points above level 12. So I was like, finally, I can get married. So what I did is just kind of like, whatever, spruced up their house a little bit, kind of added their things so that I'm not like squished into this one tiny thing. But hey, it's a box house. It looks good. It's better than what it was. So there we go. So what we did here is we got to the point where I'm level 12. I pull out the wedding arc and I, you know, pulled out these two extra, I don't know, they needed me to put this like plotted plant and then some other thing they required in order for you to actually get married. And I was excited because I figured I can finally complete my Sim's life goal, who is the female Sim. And I was like, oh, okay, this is perfect. She'll finally, you know, clear that up. Oh, that's a story for later after they get married. But anyway, so I clicked on this. I'm pulling out these things that they need me to have in order to have this wedding and whatnot. And I used my male Sim to click on it. And it was like, oh, you now have a quest. So the first thing that you have to do is, it says you can't get married until you're engaged. So I was like, oh, great. Now I have to go up another level. So I did. I actually had to turn them into soulmates, which is another level of relationship. So in order to get engaged, you know, I might be able to get married, but you can't get married without being engaged. So it's like, once you think you're there, and it's like, it's just, oh, God, it's so annoying. But anyway, so we're at this point. He bent down on one knee, he pulled out something and proposed to her, and she's like, I'll take it. And she puts on the ring, and, you know, they give a little kiss. It's pretty much the same as far as, like, any other Sims game that I've ever played. There we go, level 10. They're now a soulmate, so I had to get to level 10. I think I was at level 8 last time, so, just too much. So, at this point, once you propose, a little quest pops up, and this quest actually allows you to look at what you need in order to get married. So you have to have at least 3 friends, which he only had 2 out of 3. Then after you have that, you have to work on your wedding vows by clicking on the table, and then you have to reassure your partner that the cold feet, you know, are going to be okay. So I went ahead and I didn't show it on screen, but I went and I found another friend there so that I can I just have the third friend that it requires. He spent a couple seconds here kind of going through all that, and then he's going to talk to her, reassure cold feet, and she's like, oh, okay, I guess everything's going to be fine. We're going to be married and everything's going to be great. And he's like, yeah, see, that's what I said. So I finished this stage. You get some rewards, and then you're on to part two, which is that actual getting married part. All right, so he clicked the arc. He said, get married to Marlene. So he pulls out a ring, and they keep repeating this step continuously for, like, I think it's like a minute or so. So I cut it out because it's like the same thing over and over. It's not like they did anything. It's not like they did anything different. And once they were married, this other little screen pops up and they hug and they kiss. And congratulations, Marlene Bush and Duke Witt are now married. So you click OK, you go back. They give you all your reward points, everything like that. And it tells you that the quest was completed. You get even more experience points, and you've basically completed that quest. So, like, it's like an actual event of getting married. Now, here's the part that bothered me. It didn't even complete her life goal. I guess she was the one that had to actually initiate that. And I was like, wow, really? So I kind of lost the opportunity there for her to do that. So now that they were married, I was like, you know what? End of story. Let's do this. Time to have a baby. So I pulled out the Stork's Visit Bassinet, which, you know, was part of this quest. So I laid it down there. So now we're good to go. We have an actual... Now, I clicked on the bed thinking that that's where you have the baby or whatnot, but apparently it's not. You have to click the bassinet, and the bassinet itself actually has it. So you can have a baby with your partner and have either a boy or a girl randomly, or you can adopt a boy or adopt a girl. So you can choose what you want, or you can just randomly let it happen. So here we go. She wanted to have a baby with her soulmate, Duke. And just like any other Sims game that you've played, they go under the covers and they woohoo until they, feel that it's a good enough time for them to have the baby. So once this process is over here and the animations are done and all that, the baby pops out. And there you go. Congratulations. It's a girl. Give her a name. So I just kind of used the randomizer to find something good that I liked. I was like, I think, I don't remember. Oh, was it Eileen? No, not Marlene. Amelia. That's what I named her. Okay. Amelia Bush. Done. So as soon as I named her and all that, there you go. Now I have a little baby in the bassinet, and it's little cutie pie. Nothing much you can do with it other than feed it or play with it. And yeah, that was kind of, I was like, all right, well, I guess you can feed it and play with it, and that's it. Now, I don't know what happens from here. I don't know if the baby ages. I don't know how all that works, but I'm going to keep playing and see what happens. I did buy a toddler high chair, so I don't know, maybe something will happen. Maybe in a day or two, she'll grow up. So that's it, guys. We finally got married and we had a baby. So with that said, I hope you all enjoyed this video, and we will talk soon. Bye, guys.